Good morning, everyone. And very meticulously elaborated by Mr. Abhishek on the paper 4, that is ethics. I want you all, let's say, to develop an insight into the perspective, because today the KSG has taken an initiative to invite all the toppers, I mean, across the spectrum. And this particular seminar has been arranged with the purpose that every topper has been assigned a particular function on the basis of the functional approach. Meaning thereby, every topper will be deliberating upon the different issues across the spectrum, which will give you a valuable insight into the perspective. For example, Mr. Atul will be deliberating exclusively upon the PT perspective, because of late, it has been observed that the PT has become a very dicey phenomena. There are very good students who can write very well answers, but still they are not able to crack the PT examination. So Atul will take simply on the PT, and then let's say Sandeep will take on the mains examination. Mr. Avdhesh will again put before you a very diversified perspective. And moreover, you, because you are sitting here, you should play your level best to understand and absorb the matured aspect of this examination, which will be imparted by these particular toppers. So now, I invite Mr. Avdhesh to deliberate over the mains perspective, especially. And he is the topper of the IIT Delhi. He has secured a very good rank in the engineering services. So definitely he would be imparting the very valuable insights into the perspective.
Hello friends. So first of all, let me start by introducing myself. My name is Avdhesh Meena, and I got All India rank 32 in this UPSC 2016. This was my first attempt. I also got All India rank 9th in engineering service examination. And as sir already told that I was among the topper in the civil engineering department of IIT Delhi. My optional was civil engineering, and I got the highest marks in optionals. I got 356 marks in optionals. So I would discuss on two basic things. One is GS paper 3, and one is optional. Should we take engineering as an optional or not? So first of all, I'm telling about that fear factor which sir was talking about. So when you guys have decided that you will go for civil service preparation, then I think there should be no doubt in your mind that you should choose a backup or you should go for any other job. So once you have decided that you will go for civil services, then you should be focused. So if you want to clear it in first attempt, you should have a clear cut focus that you would focus only on civil services and you would not focus on any other examination or any other preparation. So that would help in clearing in first attempt. Also, whenever you are studying, you should not think of the result. So whenever I did study, I never focused on what the result would be. I was only like, if I'm doing hard and if I'm doing good, I will get selected. So that will help take away the fear factor which sir was talking about. So now talking whether we should take engineering as an optional. So I think engineering is a very good optional. So there are two, three rumors about engineering, especially about scaling, that there is scaling in engineering, and for if you want to score 250 marks, you will have to get to 450 and then the numbers would be scaled down. But what I see from my papers, and especially in paper 1, I have got 213 marks out of 250. So if there was any concept of scaling, then I might have got even more than 250 marks. Then only I can get 213 marks. So if there is scaling, I think that even if there is scaling, that is not that much significant. Or if it is significant, we should not worry about it. So those who are choosing engineering as an optional, they should not worry about the scaling aspect, that whether there is scaling or not. Although I agree the course is very huge. The course for civil engineering or any other engineering optional is huge, and when you start preparation, you will feel like that it would take very much time. But once you have completed with your preparation, you can be very sure of getting good marks. So for choosing your engineering as an optional, you can take 2-3 factors into account. So if you have very good knowledge base about engineering, so if you have cleared engineering service examination or you were among the toppers in your college in engineering, so you can take engineering in that case. Also, if you have interest but you didn't study that much in college and you think that you have the required aptitude or skills, then you can go for engineering optional. But if you feel that despite trying too hard, you have not been able to score good marks in engineering in your college, or you were not able to understand the concept, then I think you can go for other optional, and especially if you have interest and good writing skills in other optionals. But engineering too is a very good optional. So how to study for engineering? So I studied mostly the coaching notes which are available in the market. I studied for a total of 6 to 7 months, especially for civil engineering. So the coaching notes which were available in the market were almost sufficient, and they have to be supplemented along with the previous year papers. So there is a difference between the engineering service examination and the civil service examination in that respect, and there is a slight difference in courses and the type of questions which are asked in the examination. So in that case, you could refer previous year papers, and for the topics which were not there in the engineering service examination, I referred previous year papers and solved questions from them. So that helped me getting good marks. Apart from it, joining test series is very, very important in especially in engineering optional, where you can practice more and more questions. Practicing is the key for engineering optional. And the standard coaching material, I think, which is available is sufficient for engineering optional. So this was about, I think, engineering. So if you have questions, you can ask later. About GS paper 3, I would say that for economics portion, the class notes which would be taught in coaching along with the current affairs. The paper 3 is most of dynamic, and I got about 122 marks in paper 3. So it is more of dynamic paper. Most of the questions are related to current affairs only, the internal security part, the S&T part. So many of the questions were related to current affairs. So your focus should be on the analytical part. You should try to analyze more and more questions and more news which is coming up. So suppose there is any news relating to demonetization or the bank NPAs which are going up. So it is sure that one question would be asked from it. So if agricultural suicides are going on, so there would be something related to these things in paper. So you have to be analytical. You should try to, when you read a newspaper article or anything, you should try to be analyzed. That why are these suicides happening? What are the reasons? And what are the possible solutions for it? And in the examination, you have to, in that case, if you have already analyzed while reading the newspaper or while reading any article, then you could directly mention all those points. So that would be very, very helpful. And in S&T paper, you have to go through all the basic terms which are being given in the syllabus. So always there is question from the topics which are mentioned in syllabus. So this year there was question from nanotechnology. Last year there was question from artificial intelligence. So there were questions from each of the topics, so every year. So go through syllabus, go through each and every term of it, and have notes for each and every term of it, and then revise it. Apart from it, security also is most of, it is from current affairs only. So that too should be based on your analysis. So whenever there is news regarding internal security, like suppose there is some terrorist attack or left-wing extremism attack, so in that case you should try to analyze, and most of the questions would be from newspaper only. I felt that most questions were from newspaper. So you should try to analyze. Apart from it, you should try to work on answer writing. So even KSG have started an answer writing program. So they are working very, very hard on answer writing practice. So you should follow answer writing on a regular basis. You could start answer writing when you have prepared for about 3 to 4 months. So after 3 to 4 months of preparation, I think when you have some basic form of knowledge, you could start answer writing practice, and then you can join test series. So practicing test series regularly would help you improve your answer writing skills. So there are certain things which must be kept in mind while writing answers. Like suppose I wrote the answers in points, where I wrote an introduction and conclusion. So you should write in such a manner. You should highlight the important words. So if you, or also if you mention some facts in economics, like some, if you have some knowledge about, like what are the GDP of India, what are the subsidies which are going on. So if you have some factual knowledge, that too would add to your answer in economics portion especially. So the examiner would feel that, okay, he has some substantial knowledge, which is substantiating with use of facts. So in economics, some factual knowledge should may be remembered, especially for use in the part. Apart from it, using examples in answer. So these are all the strategies So, I've also heard about using the flowcharts and diagrams in answers, if possible. In geography, we can use diagrams, but in economics also, we can use facts and some flowcharts or tables or graphs for explaining the answers. All these are things which help to improve marks. So you should practice more and more of answer writing in GS3. So GS3 is more of current affairs, analysis and answer writing. So this was about GS3 and civil engineering optional. Thank you.
Whether we should take the optional subject as a civil engineering. Now whatever he said is absolutely correct, but again, of late it has been observed that securing in the pure sciences by taking it as an optional subject is definitely a difficult exercise. I mean, unless, let's say, if a person like Avdhesh, who has simply got the spark of a genius and he has secured, let's say, civil engineering 356, which is again a hilarious task. But my suggestion will again be that you should take the calibrated efforts depending upon your own subjective perspective. Taking the optional subjective is absolutely a subjective decision. And even the students from the core of the pure sciences, they have also opted for the, I mean, the social sciences and scored well. For example, Mr. Athar is sitting among us and he is also an engineer from the IIT, but I think he secured the rank 2 by the social sciences. So Avdhesh is absolutely correct, because the point is that scoring in civil engineering 356, I mean, it's not the everybody's cup of tea. So that way he is correct.